not because he is macroing pretty well, but it's not just because he's macroing well, it's because he just has not a lot of SUVs.
Alright, so how many mutas do we have on the field now? It looks like we have 3 in production and
16.
14 in that group. So
16.
In that group? Oh, more are coming over. I see. Alright. Hey.
look at the units tab. You don't need to count
everything. It says 19, bro. It says 19.
Oh my
All
god.
Right.
I can't count, I guess, then.
Oh, you're talking about the unit tab. I was looking at the control groups.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, control groups so good. Alright, so Art of War actually with pretty good creep spread here. Only one creep tumor going down the right side, but a bunch going down the left side with that queen just popping them in all the time. That sounded really dirty for some reason.
Yeah, pop those creep tumors out.
And upgrades currently at 1-1 for a Zerg player, getting 2 attack, and 0-0 for the Terran player. Finishing up 1-1 though, so not going to be too far behind, assuming it finishes before all 800 of these Banelings. I say 800, but realistically I mean about 20.
Yeah, and to be more exact, it's 21 Banelings. I'm just saying.
Oh, alright.
And anyway, God, so this mutas are gonna, these mutas are going to come around this side, trying to harass a lot more. And every SUV that Deceive loses right now is just a kick in the face. It's really, really not good, I guess you could say. And look at this drop that's coming for Deceive. It's going to go right by these mutas, and it's going to get sniped. Wow.
Oh my goodness.
That sucks.
It looks like +2 is going to get sniped too, and, you know, all these Marines are coming over, going to chase the mutas off, but... How many medevacs do we have out for our Terran player right now? One?
One.
God. You exactly. are just in love with potatoes. I don't even know how else to explain it. Idaho raised.
There is no other way to explain it.
Alright, so that medevac is going to come along the right-hand side. And, well, Art of War with a large army in the middle. Going to meet up with his Mutalisks here.
And it looks like he just might be going for a push, and there he goes, running to siege tanks, a lot of Marines and a lot of siege tanks, but so many Zerglings and so many Banelings and Mutas is going to clean up everything, and it looks like
excellent siege tank hits on the Banelings, though, giant ball of them, and Art of War, I mean, is way up in supply, but is going to have to back off. This drop coming down to Art of War's main, his Mutas stopped all the way back, and this could actually clean up a lot of Art of War's tech.
No, I don't think it'll clean up anything. I think it'll drop Marines and it'll just die immediately. These mutas are upgraded, +1 attack, and he has just way too many right now.
Wow.
Art of War is
really
just on top.
Really fast reactions, yeah.
He's on top of everything. He killed that natural command center. So really, Deceive is just long-range mining. He has another one making, but, I mean, he's just going to have 2 bases still. And that's really not good compared to the 5 base right now for Art of War, or 6 bases coming up in 4 base mining, so...
So
not a good position.
Deceive right now moved out with all of his Marines, and they're actually all getting picked off by the Zerglings here in the middle of the map with the Mutas on top. And currently supplies 70 to 162 in Art of War's favor. Definitely doing a great job of forcing the Terran to not do anything.
Oh, dancing the Zerglings.
Oh.
Sorry.
And Deceive gives the GG.
I forgot.
Wait. What did you forget?
I don't know. He didn't say what he forgot. He'd like to all in back. Whoa!
Oh! I don't know if that was BM or a stylistic thing. He probably knows Art of War. All these players, you know, are at a threshold where they don't hit that many players over and over again. But,
I like how he says that and quickly leaves like shit.
Kind of funny. Alright, so we do have Art of War taking game number... All I need to do is add up the score and add 1. I'm just not capable of doing it, though. I don't know why. It seems so easy, right? I don't know, man. I don't know. All right, so we will be back with game number 7 in just a few minutes. This is a best of 9, so 1-5. And I'm going to not advertise to you guys over this break for ourselves. So enjoy it. Enjoy it. All right. All right. You're welcome. You're welcome.
You're welcome, too.
Save. You're my favorite movie. 1,000
so many buttons to press.
You whine too much.
I do whine a lot. I'm not going to lie. You know what? You whine a lot, alright? Don't even go
You
there.
Whine a lot.
Swapping the player. Oh, wait. Is that right? Yeah, that is right.
So okay. While he's screwing around with buttons, I will talk about what this map is.
So many buttons.
It is GSL Crevasse. It is a humongous map and hectic. Blue Terran spawning in the bottom left for IMP Impulse Gaming.
And on the top left, we have Art of War, our Zerg hero for Team Air. And, I don't know, man. How do you like this map for Terran? I don't play this map very often, obviously.
I don't play it that much either. I think it's a pretty old map, and it is in the GSL map pool, but I haven't seen it been played in a long time. I honestly don't know. It's a really big map, so Zerg can take a lot of expansions, but there's also a lot of cool little choke points that Terran can exploit. So it really depends. I mean, Zerg can take a quick, easy 3 expansions, so that obviously helps them. But we'll have to see what both players do. I think they will both go for some kind of really fast expansion.
And you know, something interesting about this particular version of this map, because there are an infinite number of versions of all of these maps, is that it
really?
A rich Vespaian geyser at the hidden base. I don't even know what to call it, man.
The natural?
Well, I don't know, man. I would call your natural the one outside of your base, one with 2 gas and 8 mineral patches.
What about your natural third?
That's just awkward. I don't know.
Okay, but nonetheless, Art of War is going to be taking that hatch up there first. What do you think about that? Why not take it down at the natural down there?
You know, I feel that way too a lot, because if you take that and defend it well, you take your third very, very easily up at the elbow net. I don't even know. Oh, God, it's going to be so difficult. But,
elevated.
I mean, look at the rush distance between the main and the natural if we're going to expand outside of our base. It's absolutely huge. And as Zerg, it's vital that you have queens to defend a lot of stuff, man. You can't use one spine crawler or 2 spine crawlers to defend from reactored Hellions. You have to make, like, 14 spine crawlers to defend it. And, yeah, it just gets a little ridiculous. So, I do kind of like the decision from Art of War. And also, he can do some fancy things like, you know, take that that gas up at his third very quickly, the hidden expansion very quickly, and you know, get a ton of income out of it. It could really benefit him. And oh my God, we have Art of
and
War going
BM.
For a third base at 18 supply.
Yeah, really cool decision, I guess. I don't know. It's gonna put him way far ahead normally than he would be.
Well, yeah, especially since we have our Terran player going for a 1 Rex expand. His command center is already a quarter of the way done, man.
Yeah, for sure. Sorry, I need a yawn. Those potatoes make me tired. Anyway, resume the game.
All right, so Art of War taking that third hatch very quickly. And, you know, something about taking that quick of a third hatch means you kind of don't even need queens, man. Oh, look at this. Art of War going for that rich Vespaian geyser first, immediately throwing down a roach war, and I love this. This is awesome, dude. Are you kidding me? He's gonna get to put roach pressure on and not commit that much to gas.
Yeah, he actually did this on